it was astounding to know that, like, I had this opportunity and maybe I could do something with it.
Elizabeth Snedeker has. The industrial design major at Pennsylvania College of Technology spent 4 months redesigning a common yet troublesome surgical instrument, an extractor for partial knee replacements.
I think it was not really designed with much thought as far as ergonomics go. It's just very unfriendly to the hand. It's awkward to hold it. There's just a lot of things about it that just make it not work well.
In other words, it's the perfect choice for an industrial design student's senior project.
But you see how you're holding it? It's so difficult to grip it.
Yeah. Industrial design connects art and science together. So industrial designers are combining the things that make objects work along with the way people think about things. So they're combining those two elements to come up with one unified whole.
Penn College industrial design students combine those elements for industry clients.
Industry contacts are very important to what my view is for a capstone project. In other words, the industry gets to judge the efficacy of the design rather than just me.
Snedeker's client is Zimmer Biomet, a global orthopedic company that designed and manufactured the current version of the extractor. At the end of the semester, Snedeker will offer her redesign to Zimmer Biomet officials.
Realistically, what I would like to do at the end of this is to have my design and have surgeons using my tool in order to make it more effective and efficient.
To realize that objective, Snedeker researched and studied all aspects of the current tool before moving to the ideation stage.
Ideation is mostly sketching all your ideas down on paper, like what you have written, what you have come up with, your first thoughts, just putting everything down on paper.
Namely, she's looking at the technical things. It has to do certain specific things in surgery. It has to do them well. But then there's this other side, meaning it's easy to use, as she's reading between the lines and figuring out what do they really want.
Snedeker employed engineering design software to print a 3D model of her favorite sketch to replicate the feel of the redesigned tool. Testing with a low-fidelity prototype ensured that her new design elements didn't interfere with the extractor's mechanics.
So it looks beat up and ugly, but it serves its purpose, and it thankfully and surprisingly showed that the design was successful, and it actually supplied more impact force than what was seen in the previous instrument.
She just was very thorough in her approach to this, you know, very methodical, thorough, and just wanted to make sure that, you know, any potential issues were addressed.
The senior shared her final design with college officials and engineers from Zimmer Biomet's corporate office, who joined her capstone presentation via FaceTime.
It was more of me looking at the back of a phone, but it was really nice that they were involved and even gave part into the conversation. This length was just determined to be...
The engineers saw a stylish new tool featuring a one-handle operation and a more comfortable grip.
But she really infused it with her own personality and her own vision for what the product should look like.
I thought it was fantastic. I mean, I was very shocked, I think is probably the best word to use, that somebody at her level of training would come up with a sophisticated design that, you know, that she came up with. And I think the people from Zimmer Biomet were very, very, very pleasantly surprised as well.
Company engineers are reviewing Snedeker's design and 100-plus pages of documentation. In the future, Zimmer Biomet may use her ideas to redesign the tool. Even if they don't, Snedeker is well on her way to becoming a biomedical engineer.
She's learned how to identify what problems are there from the beginning, you know, come up with creative ideas and how to address those problems, then carry them through the design process to a finished product. And I think she's learned how to do that, and she'll be able to apply those same principles to any type of design problem that she encounters in her work life. You know, she has a passion for this. It's easy to see that. And, so that will serve her well, and I think she'll be very successful.
I'm so grateful for this experience.
Maybe you can hand deliver it when you come for your interview.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.